Hello friends, glad to see you back. Today we're going to share some recent space updates with you. We'll begin as usual with recent developments in SpaceX's Starbase, then we'll share Biden's comments on Musk, and we're ending with a quite interesting update where China's going to develop their own mega rocket. Let's get started with SpaceX's Starship development progression at Starbase. For quite a long time, SpaceX's Starbase facility is getting jam-packed with various tests of Starship prototypes. And recently, they're very much occupied in preparing participants, Ship 24 and B7, for the orbital launch debut of their next-gen Starship rocket, which is most probably going to happen in December. But beside these preparations, SpaceX teams have also devoted time to constantly producing ship and super heavy boosters, as well as testing out the completed ones. And most recently, on the 8th of November, Ship 24 was again de-stacked from Booster 7. In the recent history of SpaceX's Starbase events, SpaceX teams have stacked Booster 7 and Ship 24 for the first time in the first half of October. That stack was followed by some full-stack tests, but those tests were not up to the mark as per some sources. Later, Ship 24 was de-stacked on the 16th of October. By the 20th of October, Ship 24 was reinstalled atop Booster 7, and then SpaceX initiated a series of tests, which NASA tagged as single-species prop tests, where the liquid oxygen or liquid methane tanks of either B7 or Ship 24 or both the vehicles were filled up. Nearly the same time, NASA's Aerospace Safety Advisory Panel had stated that the explosion that dented Booster 7 back in July had ultimately made SpaceX to increase systems engineering and risk management, upholding the fact that the recent tests were carried out with extra caution. After initiating those single-species prop tests on the 20th of October, SpaceX teams have carried out almost 7 such tests before dismounting Ship 24 from Booster 7 on the 7th and 8th of November. Out of those 7 tests, 4 tests contained loading of liquid oxygen or liquid methane into both the ship and booster stages, while the remaining 3 tests were carried out only upon the Super Heavy Booster 7. According to some reports, it's stated that during these single-species prop tests, tanks of both the stages were completely filled. Moreover, the propellant and oxidizer were never loaded on either stage at the same time. But this recent de-stacking of Ship 24 from Booster 7 is not surprising and seems obvious, as during the press conference held at the end of last month, NASA officials had stated that SpaceX had plans to de-stack Ship 24 before conducting additional static fire testing with Booster 7. So this present move from SpaceX is an indication that they'll soon head Booster 7 static fire tests. During August and September, Booster 7 had completed multiple static fire tests consisting of 1, 3, and 7 Raptor engines. But this number is very much smaller as compared to static fire of all 33 engines. According to sources, it's expected that during the upcoming static fire test of Booster 7, they'll at least go for firing 15 to 16 engines before heading for the final 33-engine test. While these events were happening at the orbital launch mount, on the other hand, Ship 25 was sent back to High Bay after it completed a number of cryo tests. As we know, Ship 25 was first rolled to the launch site back on the 19th of October. Report says that since rollout, Ship 25 had completed 4 proof testings. Of the 4 tests, Ship 25 had carried out its first and successful pneumatic proof test on the 28th of October. Then on the 1st, 2nd, and 7th of November, it completed the remaining 3 cryoproof tests. Later on the 8th of November, after depressurizing Ship 25, it was lifted off from the stand dedicated for proof testing, where it had been sitting for 3 weeks. Ship 25 was removed from the pad and sent back to High Bay nearly 3 hours prior to Ship 24 de-stacking. Ship 24 was not only dismounted, but was placed on another test stand on the 9th of November. As per reports, it's expected that SpaceX may possibly carry out further tests of the qualified Ship 24. Now, let's look into Biden's comments on Musk. In a recent interview, U.S. President Joe Biden mentioned Elon Musk's contacts with other nations, according to President Biden, merit investigation. The president responded that Elon Musk's relationships with other countries is worthy of being looked at when asked on Wednesday whether the CEO of Tesla, SpaceX, and Twitter posed a threat to national security. The president was specifically questioned during a White House press conference on Wednesday. Do you think Elon Musk is a threat to U.S. national security? And should the U.S., with the tools you have, investigate his joint acquisition of Twitter with foreign governments, which include the Saudis? Biden mentioned Elon Musk's cooperation and/or technical relationships with other countries is worthy of being looked at. Whether or not he's doing anything inappropriate, I'm not suggesting that. I'm suggesting it's worth being looked at, and that's all I'll say. Musk frequently criticizes Democrats and isn't a fan of Biden. Throughout the year 2022, Musk has charged that the president has ignored his successful electric vehicle company, Tesla, in favor of venerable automakers and their unions. He's promised to cast his ballot for Republicans. A few days back, on November 7th, as voters were about to cast their ballots, he tweeted, "Shared power curbs the worst excesses of both parties. Therefore, I recommend voting for a Republican Congress, given that the presidency is Democratic." Now we're on to the last and the interesting update. China originally sought to create a rocket similar to NASA's SLS, but is now aiming to construct something more closer to SpaceX's Starship. Large or little, reusable rockets are the wave of the future. And as a recently shown mock-up of the Long March 9 launch vehicle reveals, Chinese rocket experts are beginning to embrace the concept. At the recent Zhuhai Air Show, a Chinese team unveiled its improved aircraft, according to Space News. The new Long March 9 design brings to mind SpaceX's Starship and thoughts of reusability with its grid fins and visibly lacking side boosters. Elon Musk became interested in this discovery and led the charge in developing the idea and demonstrating its viability. The SpaceX CEO responded to the Space News piece by tweeting, "Rockets that aren't reusable have no future." Elon Musk might have as well specifically mentioned NASA's disposable space launch system. The development of the Orion spacecraft and the 321-foot-tall or 98-meter-tall SLS rocket cost more than $50 billion combined, and each launch of the Artemis rocket is anticipated to cost upwards of $4.1 billion, a sum that Inspector General Paul Martin has labeled unsustainable. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comment section. This will help us to improve.